Hello, since Milwaukee Tools hasn't or may not do it, I did it myself. And I seem to be the only one that now has USB-C charging adapter for the M18 battery. I'm going to demonstrate it for you. And if there's interest, I might actually sell these. And in the meantime, I do have my own. And it's a little bit of a multi-process here. Now, just so I have something to demonstrate with outside of a car, because a great use of this is charging your batteries on the go. If you're out and about, it eliminates the need for a costly power inverter. And also, in general, even the smallest M18 battery chargers cannot charge off of your 12-volt socket / cigarette outlet in your car. The wattage is low enough, however, the volt amperes is too high due to the poor power factor, which would exceed, I'd say, almost all 12-volt sockets in the majority of vehicles. You'd have to connect something straight to your car's battery, unless your car has a built-in power inverter. So, in this case, we're going to use a 12-volt car phone and laptop charger that has USB-C. I do have a little meter plugged into it right here so you guys can see it working. I am using one of my little jumpstart adapters connected to a M18 HD12 Milwaukee battery. That's just so I don't have to have a lead-acid battery sitting on here. And we're going to charge this M18 battery. It's down to 2 bars. And another nice thing is it also comes with a wall outlet adapter, so you could use this in your home or on a job site, which is actually slower than using USB-C. So I have my special little cable here, USB-C on one end and a little barrel plug on the other. So that will go into here. And we're going to plug that into there. Now again, this is just a meter that shows us how much power things are being drawn. Flashing green light means it's ready. And we're going to do a little zoom in here. And right now you can see the meter is triggered with my special cable for 20 volts. The downside is, well, on the plus side is we're using the USB-C protocol, which natively supports 20 volts as long as your adapter or charging adapter can provide 20 volts. The downside is a fully charged M18 battery is actually going to be about 21 volts. So you won't get to 100% charge. It'll be more of around a 90 to a 95% charge, which actually could make your M18 batteries last a little longer. So, light is red. It's charging. You can see that going there. And we look down here. We're going to move the camera again. And you can actually see we are charging the battery at 27.8 watts. You can reset this. So this is only charging at about half the speed that the standard non-rapid charger M18 chargers charge at, which is around 60 watts, give or take. Now the drop in voltage is of course due to the power draw. That'll go up and it'll fluctuate a little bit as the battery fills up. The voltage shown would go up too. But this is just to show that it is indeed charging the battery. And I built these using all off-the-shelf parts. There is a little bit of modification I have to do inside here versus the off-the-shelf one for some current limiting, so we don't go frying anybody's portable chargers. But it, so far it's been working. I've been testing this for a couple weeks now. It's great just being able to pop a dead battery on while I'm driving around going from service call to service call. And, you know, yes, of course, I charge them all up much quicker at home. But it's great having that backup when you need it. If you're interested in buying one, my email address is in the description box of the video. And right now, my lead time is probably going to be about 2 weeks. I got a few parts coming from China. Unfortunately, I couldn't source anything or everything here in the U.S. but I can do it a few different ways. You can get just the charger cable and then the wall charger. I think I can do that for around $40. If you want an appropriately sized car plug, we're looking at about 55, and that'd be shipped within the continental USA. I can also get them with Euro chargers for European style plugs, either way. And tell me what you think. It'd be great if Milwaukee came out with one. I know Skill actually just came out. Their new Skill batteries actually have the USB-C port built right in, which is awesome. The hard part just is due to the higher voltage of the M18 batteries. And trying to initiate or step up the voltage. But that's the nice thing about USB-C is that it natively supports 20 volts. Actually, I think it goes higher than that and up to 100 watts depending on your charger. I started off with this one because I can actually charge my laptop with it at full power. So it's still chugging away. It's working. We're drawing 28.2 watts now. And 1.49 amps. I did test this with a number of different input voltages. Just the electronics in here without any more major modifications. We're looking at needing a 40 watt or less car charging adapter that supports 20 volt output. And if it doesn't support 20 volt output, it will not work because we're not stepping up the voltage. There's no step up, no buck boost converter. We are actually using USB-C's native 20 volt support, which cut down big time on the number of components. Any questions, post them in the description box below. If you like the video, please hit thumbs up and subscribe. I got another video coming where we made a Milwaukee snow blower, or I guess you could technically call it a Milwaukee powered power shovel, which works absolutely amazing as well. So I got videos on that coming up too, and minimum modifications are required to make that work. So